Yo, what's going on, guys? Sinister Skater here, and welcome to First Try Fridays episode number 10. For those of you just finding my channel, this is a series I do every single Friday where you guys leave a comment of any Call of Duty Ghost class you'd like to see me use in a game down below. And then each and every Friday, I go in and randomly pick one of the classes and use it in my very first game of Call of Duty Ghosts for the day. And I upload and get a little commentary going for that gameplay, no matter if it's really good or really poor. So this week, the class was suggested by Hotshot, who wanted me to use the Riot Shield. He didn't have a class, but he just wanted me to use the Riot Shield. But I do remember that he did have a Riot Shield class that he posted earlier, so I kind of pulled some things from that class comment. But overall, the class I'm using is the Riot Shield with Titanium Frame, which allows me to melee faster. And then we got the P226 dual Akimbo wield, whatever you want to call it, pistols, as well as the C4. And the perks I'm using is Ready Up, Strong Arm, Reflex, Steady Aim, Extra Lethal, and Gambler. And then we're using the support package this time with the SATCOM squad mate and the Hilo Scout. And we went 24 and 18 overall, which is actually pretty decent with the Riot Shield. Got 27 tags, playing some kill confirmed on Sovereign. And that's the gameplay. We are using what I called one of the worst weapons in Call of Duty history, this Riot Shield that I named in last week's First Try Fridays. And we're going to be continuing off of last week's topic with the top 5 best guns in Call of Duty history. Last week, like I said, we did top 5 worst guns. And if you would like to see that video, there is a link down in the description to the previous First Try Fridays episode, as always. So you can go ahead and click that, and it will take you right to that video. So, the top 5 best guns in Call of Duty history ever. You can say best guns or OP guns. You know, overpowered guns, they're always good, so we're just going to go ahead and say best guns because, you know, they pretty much mean the same thing. And this was pretty hard, like I said. I had a list of, again, about 12 guns, and it was really hard to pick 5 out of them. We actually have an honorable mention because this weapon, it kind of was a weapon, and it didn't really fit. I mean, it just needed to be mentioned. And that one thing before we get started with this list is the noob tubes from Modern Warfare 2. Now, some of you might be like slapping your face right now and be like, oh my god, why did you just say that? But to be honest, those were good weapons. I mean, a good attachment weapon, whatever you want to call it. You can use one man army and you could just noob tube for days, killed easily, and you could basically have unlimited ammo. And you know, there's no, like, again, the whole history behind it and the story behind why they're called noob tubes now, grenade launcher, whatever you want to call it, it is from this MW2 because they were so OP and easy to use, easy for noobs to use. But you can't deny that that was a good weapon. So with that out of the way, let's start off with number one. Again, these are in no particular order like last week, but number one on this top 5 weapons list are the FMG9s Akimbo in MW3 before they got patched. Now, if you guys didn't play MW3, or if you did play, you might remember if you used these in the beginning of the game, these things were freaking awesome. I had them on every single class. I remember specifically moments in games where I was actually playing with friends and we were on different teams because they joined the game and everything like that. And I kept using them. I was absolutely destroying people on the other team, and they're all complaining about it because these things were amazing. They spit. The fire rate on these were amazing. The hit fire was, like, accurate. You could spray people down across the map. They killed real fast. And before they got patched, they did patch these because they were pretty overpowered after the first month or however long it was. But these things were absolutely amazing. FMG9s were, for sure, one of my favorite guns to use before they got patched in Call of Duty history. Coming in next on the list is the all-famous ACR from Modern Warfare 2. This gun was basically your laser rifle. This thing had no recoil whatsoever. Had a good amount of damage. You could pick people off across map, no problem. You can just hold that trigger down and spray without burst firing or whatever, and you could just, again, mow people down. No doubt this was one of the most favorite guns in Modern Warfare 2 by most of the community, and a lot of people did use it. So next we got the third best top 5 weapon is the MP40 from World at War. If you guys did not use this thing, you were on crack, because this thing, I can say, was probably overpowered. It killed in like 2 shots for an SMG, and even when they had like a juggernaut, whatever that thing was called, it killed in like 3 to 4 shots. Killed really fast, had a decent amount of like recoil so you can control it easily, and it had a huge clip. And if you put the dual mags on the weapon, it was the SMG, you got like, if you started with 32, I think, if you put dual mags on, you got 64 bullets, and you could just spray down and kill people. Again, like I said, it killed like 2 shots. you know, sometimes one shot to the head, depending on the shot. But this thing just mowed people down. Again, you could just sit here and spray for like a minute straight and just kill people. It was insane gun. If you haven't seen it, look up some like MP40 gameplay on YouTube. The thing was insane. Number four we got on the list, no doubt, was the the Model 1887's Akimbo in Modern Warfare 2, again, pre-patch. And these things had pretty much no limit to its range. It did an insane amount of damage, and it had that little cool animation when you shot it, you like swung it back with the like little lever and cocked it and then shot it again, which made it kind of cool that way. But these things, like, I've actually seen people where you could like shoot all the way across the map on like a huge map and they get a hit marker. Like, you're not gonna kill the dude, but they got a hit marker because these things had like no range before they got patched. You could just walk into a room, again, you had like Akimbo, and one shot from one could like kill a dude all the way across the room. So you can unleash one shot on that guy, turn around, get the other dude, and then by the time you take that shot, you already had your other shot and the other gun ready. So you could just tear down a whole room in like 4 seconds. These things were insanely OP. That's why they did get patched, but that was one of the definite best guns in Call of Duty history. And then the last gun we have on my top five list is the FAMAS from Black Ops 1. Definitely the go-to weapon for pros, for pubs. This thing, you know, it was awesome. They didn't nerf it later on, but the nerf didn't do that much to it to make it that bad. But again, this gun had a nice, decent rate of fire, easy to control, recoil, killed pretty fastly, and definitely was one of the standout weapons in Black Ops for sure. And that's my top five list. Again, you guys can leave comments down below if you guys agree with it. You can leave your top five comments, anything, any kind of feedback, leave it down below, because I do like seeing what you guys like to say. And next week, we will probably be continuing this with like top five best maps, or maybe, I don't know why, I just popped in my head, but like perks, maybe probably maps, do something to do with maps. Or you can leave some ideas down below in the comments again. And finally, for the comments, make sure you leave one for First Try Fridays next week. Make sure you leave a class down below right now if you haven't done so. And as always, guys, thanks for watching. I'm Sinister Skater, and I hope you guys enjoyed. Peace out.